Division of segments and angles, level 2. In this video, we will apply the concepts learned from the previous video to solve basic problems related with division of segments and angles. Let's go ahead and start with the first example. In the following diagram, segment RS is congruent to segment ST. Can we conclude that point S is the midpoint of segment RT? In this problem, we are provided with a figure and are asked to determine if a point is a midpoint of a segment. Recall that a midpoint of a segment divides a segment into two congruent segments. At first glance, this seems to be the case since we are given that segment RS is congruent to segment ST. Unfortunately, point S is not the midpoint of segment RT. In order for a point to be considered a midpoint, it has to be collinear with the endpoints of the segment. Looking at the diagram, we see that point R, point S, and point T are not collinear, so point S cannot be a midpoint. This is an example of a special case where two segments that share the same point are congruent, and yet the common point between the segments is not a midpoint. All right. Let's try the next example. In the following diagram, ray BD bisects angle ABC. Can we conclude that ray DB bisects angle ADC? In this problem, we are provided with a figure and are asked to determine if a ray bisects an angle. We're given that ray BD bisects angle ABC. This means that ray BD will split angle ABC into two congruent angles. In this case, angle ABD is congruent to angle CBD. Now, just because it looks like ray DB is a bisector of angle ADC does not mean that it is. We cannot assume this from the diagram. We need to determine this with the given information. Notice that segment AD, DC, CB, and BA may or may not be the same length. We have no way of determining this, so the angle may or may not be bisected by ray DB. So in the end, we do not have enough information to reach that conclusion. Okay, let's take a look at the next example. In the following diagram, point B and point C trisect segment AD. Can we conclude that ray EB and ray EC trisect angle AED? In this problem, we are provided with a figure and are asked to determine if two rays trisect an angle. We are given that point B and point C trisect segment AD. In other words, segment AB is congruent to segment BC, which is congruent to segment CD. Notice that it is true that segment AB is congruent to both segment BC and CD, but the fact that segment AD has been trisected does not mean that angle AED has also been trisected. We would need more information to draw a decisive conclusion. So no, we cannot conclude that ray EB and ray EC trisect angle AED. Now let's take a look at some proof examples. Given that ray PS bisects angle RPO, prove that angle RPS is congruent to angle OPS. In this problem, we are provided with some geometric relations and a diagram. We are asked to show or prove that two angles are congruent. We're going to use a two-column proof to show that these two angles are congruent. Let's start by marking the diagram with the given information. In this case, we are given that ray PS bisects angle RPO. This means that angle RPS will be congruent to angle OPS. So let's mark these two angles with single arc marks. Now that we have a labeled diagram, let's go ahead and prove the conjecture. We will start with the given information. In this case, ray PS bisects angle RPO. And the reason is because it is given. With this statement, we can conclude that angle RPS is congruent to angle OPS. And the reason is because if a ray bisects an angle, it divides the angle into two congruent angles. This is essentially the definition of an angle bisector. And this ends the proof. Alright, let's try the next proof. Given that line CM bisects segment AB, prove that segment AM is congruent to segment MB. In this problem, we are provided with a conjecture and a diagram. We are asked to prove that two line segments are congruent. We're going to once again use a two-column proof to show that these two line segments are congruent. Let's start by marking the diagram with the given information. In this case, we are given that line CM bisects segment AB. So we are going to draw a single tick mark on line segment AM and line segment MB. Now let's proceed with the proof. For our first statement, we will write line segment CM bisects segment AB. And the reason is because it is given. Now we can conclude that segment AM is congruent to segment MB. Because if a line bisects a segment, it divides the segment into two congruent segments. This is essentially the definition of a segment bisector. And this ends the proof. Let's move along to the final example. Given that segment DH is congruent to segment HF, prove that point H is the midpoint of segment DF. In this problem, we are provided with a geometric relation along with a diagram. We are asked to prove that a point is the midpoint of a line segment. Similar to the previous examples, let's first mark the diagram with the given information. We are given that segment DH is congruent to segment HF. So we draw a single tick mark on each of these two segments in the diagram. Next, we will use a two-column proof to show that point H is the midpoint of segment DF. We will start with the given information. In this case, segment DH is congruent to segment HF. And the reason is because it is given. From here, we can conclude that point H is the midpoint of segment DF because if a point divides a segment into two congruent segments, then it is the midpoint of the segment. This is essentially the definition of a midpoint. And this ends the proof. Alright, in our next video, we will go over more basic examples involving division of segments.